Okay, so this is everything that you are going to need to dye your hair. Now, like I said before, I'm just going to be retouching my roots, but it is pretty much the same concept. You're going to need a mixing bowl, which I have right here. This one, everything I purchased is from Sally's. This is just the Color Icon mixing bowl. So you're going to need that. And then I use a brush to pick up the color, which you'll see in the video later on, and put that color on my hair. And then I also have a whisk, a little whisk right here. You could find these anywhere, really. I picked mine up at Sally's. I use that to just make sure all the colors mixed. The red hair dye that I'm going to be using has larger particles, so they are harder to break up. So I'm going to be using that. This I just have, it comes with 10. It's just a shower cap. You can use a plastic bag. You don't need to use a shower cap, but I just cover my hair with that after I'm done so I don't get hair dye anywhere. Anywhere, you know, that doesn't need to be. And I also am going to be using a protein filler. This just ensures that your color is going to be dispersed evenly with my roots and with my ends that are a little bit more drier than the rest of my hair. I would think a protein filler really helps to disperse the color evenly. You're also going to need your color. I have bought two boxes, and the color that I am using is the L'Oreal Excellence High Color Highlights. It's for dark hair only, in the color magenta. The reason that I got two of them is because I'm going to do one for the majority of my hair, and I'm going to use the other one for my roots. Now, for that, I'm going to be using, as I drop everything, as usual, I'm going to be using a 20 vol developer on my roots because it is not going to lighten as much, which I don't really need on my roots because it is virgin hair, so it's going to lighten fairly well. And then I have a 40 vol developer for the rest of my hair. Now, last time I used a 30 vol and it wasn't as bright as I wanted it to be, so hopefully keep your fingers crossed that the 40 volume developer turns out the way that I want it to. Lastly, you are going to need a pair of gloves. I just bought these reusable latex gloves. I have a couple pairs of them, but I lose them and whatnot. So, and then you're going to need a really good deep conditioner. I normally would use my Macadamia Natural Oils mask, but I am out of that currently, so I'm going to be mixing Ion Repair Solutions and probably Beyond the Zone Last Call hair mask. So I'm going to be mixing both of that at the end once I rinse out my color. So, all right, so that is everything that you need, and let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to do, oh, I think I forgot to mention this, is I have a little beaker to measure out. It's a 2:1 ratio. I'm going to start off by opening up a packet of color. Like I said, this is the L'Oreal Excellence High Color Highlights for dark hair only, and this is in the color magenta. So it just comes in a little tube like that. So what you're going to want to do is just twist off the top and pop it like that. And then you're just going to squeeze all of the product in it. Okay, so like I said, it's a 2:1 ratio. So what I'm going to do first is I am going to take my 20 volume cream developer and I'm going to add two parts of that to this mixture because I'm going to start off by doing my roots. And I did buy the protein filler. I'm not going to be using that in there because it should my roots should take pretty well because they're virgin hair, so. So there's 1.2 ounces in the hair color, and I'm going to add 2.4 ounces to the mixture. Like I said, this is the 20 volume, and this is what I'm going to be using on my roots. The higher volume you have, cream developer wise, the more intense your color is going to be. So I'm going to use the 40 on the rest of my hair and the 20 on my roots. So I'm just going to take my whisk and make sure that everything is mixed really well. You want to make sure that you get all that, the chunky parts out of it. Make sure when you're doing this you have a shirt that you, you put a shirt on that you really don't care about in case you get dye on yourself, because hair dye is hard enough to get out on its own, let alone clothes or anything of importance. Okay, so once you're done with that, you should have something that kind of looks like a red velvet cake mixture, and you are ready to begin. So I'm just going to go and put a different shirt on and put my gloves on, and then we're ready to get started. Okay, guys, so I don't know how well you're going to be able to tell, but this is the hair situation that I have going on right now, and hopefully maybe you'll be able to tell that it is a different color on the tips of my hair. That is because they I'm in need of a trim, and I have some root situation going on here. So we are going to fix all that. Before I get started, I'm just going to brush my hair out so it's easier for the color to get in there. And what I'm going to do is just go ahead and just start by applying the color to my roots and just work in sections all the way around my head. And then I will go back and I will mix the second box of color with the 40 volume developer to do the rest of my hair. Let it sit anywhere from like 30 minutes to an hour. They recommend 30 minutes. I personally always leave my hair color on a little bit longer, but let me stress this to you guys. I am not a professional. This is just what I do. I'm just showing you guys what I do. So if this is something you think you could do, you know, you see the way that I'm doing it. But again, you can find anything you want on YouTube, the internet, search. I have done my research, so that is why I am able to do this comfortably and able to share my experience with you guys. So make sure whenever you're doing something new for the first time, you do a lot of research on it. I have my gloves on, and I'm also just going to take, I think I forgot to mention this earlier, this Repel Skin Shield Guard. It's pretty much the exact same thing as Vaseline. I just have this lying around. Right now, I'm just going to start by putting it all over the areas that I would normally get the most color on my face. This is going to make it a whole lot easier to remove the color once I'm done. Not as much work for me. I didn't really like to put it down here. And around my ears and like in the back of my ears is generally where I get the most color. They do have ear like protector guards. They look like little shower caps for your ears. I don't know. If I had them, I'd probably forget to use them anyway, so this works just fine. So once you've done that, it's time to get started. So once again, we're going to be starting off with my roots. We'll be right back. color to your hair, you should have something like this. I am just going to take my clear plastic shower cap and place that over my head. And just let it sit for about 30 minutes to an hour. We'll see how it looks. And then I will wash it out and let you see what it looks like. Okay, guys, I'll see you soon. Bye. Okay, so here it is, guys. This is what the final product looks like. This is how it turned out. All in all, I'm really happy with it. I was a little bit nervous because I had so much of my roots showing that I was a little concerned how it was going to show out, but it definitely came out how I wanted it. It is a little bit brighter. I don't know if you guys can tell. It is a little bit brighter on my roots, but again, that is because it is virgin hair, so it's obviously the color is going to take better to my roots than it would any other place along my hair, but I'm very, very happy with it. So that is what it looks like. I know you guys always comment how I play with my hair too much, and I'm really sorry about that, but I hope this video was helpful. I know it's kind of rambled and all over the place, but it's actually super, super late at night right now, and I was trying to get it up and trying to get it filmed and done before the day was over because I do have to go to work early in the morning. But I wanted to get this video up. I wanted to get it filmed for you guys, and I didn't want to wait any longer, so this is what it looks like. So this is how I got my hair to be this color red. So yeah, I know this video is seriously all over the place and it's probably going to be like forever long. So I'm going to keep it short. I'm going to cut myself off. So if you guys have any questions or if there's anything that I didn't answer in the video, please, 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 guys, feel free to either leave me a comment or inbox me a message. I will do my best to answer. So I hope you guys found this helpful. Again, I am not a professional, so this is just what I do to get my hair this color. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoy, and I will talk to you soon. Bye.